must be great riding with him.
Look out! Look out! Look out! Look out!
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the channel. And to all the new subscribers, hello. I hope you enjoy this random junk I chuck up. And I guess you're here for the Honda C90 action. Or the e-bike stuff, either or. Anyway, February the 4th, and today is my very first ride on the bike. I've bought it in November last year, 20th of November last year. And then I've been faffing around, put the new engine in, a few bits and bobs, and I've finally gone and got it taxed and insured. That was a bit of a faff, to be honest, because when I was trying to get insurance, once I put the new engine in, it kept showing up on the DVLA system with the insurance brokers that it was still an 85cc bike. And I'd say, no, anyway, they didn't want to touch it. So I got the new V5 with my name. I then sent it off to get the engine, the new engine put on, the 107 Lifan. I got that back, and then I phoned a few brakers to try and get some insurance. And my goodness gracious me, you'd have think I'd have chucked a feckin' rocket engine in there. So I phoned a few brokers, and they explained the situation. I said it's now a 107. They then spoke to their underwriters. I was on hold. They got back to me, and they said the underwriters want to know what bike the engine came out of. And I said, it didn't. It came out of a box from a shelf. So they went back to the underwriters, and they came back again and said, well, yeah, they want to know what bike. I said, look, it didn't. It came from a box off a shelf, and I just put it in. It's an engine kit. Anyway, they kind of got the concept, and the prices they were coming back with was bloody ridiculous. It's a bloody Placky Bomber step through, for goodness sake. I think he was coming in at like 330 quid fully comp, and then 270 odd quid third party. Oh yeah, but because it's a different, oh, Jesus Christ. I just knocked that on the head, and I got in touch with A-Plan, Howdens, formerly A-Plan. I'd already got a quote from them with it being a 90, and I explained the situation, put a new engine in it, and they said, yeah, no problem, tap, 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 and they came back and said, £99. I went, what? Are you serious? I said, just check, that is a 107 engine, in that, yep, £99, fully comp. Wowzer, I bought it there and then. And the guy at Howden's A-Plan, Shelley, I think. He just said, yeah, we deal with a lot of people like this who customise bikes, blah-de-blah-de-blah. And it's my policy is with Ageas. So yeah, £99, fully comp. I took out breakdown cover with it just in case. I was going to do that anyway through Green Flag, and it's a similar price. So I chucked that on the insurance. So there we go, fully road legal, taxed, insured, MOT. And my first ride, my partner's gone down to the horse field to do some schooling in the horse playground, that square area with soft stuff, and she's asked me to go and video it because she wants to check out what this horse is doing movement wise. So rather than take the car, it's a good opportunity to take the Placky Bomber, because I've got to go and get some milk as well. So it's only about a 15 minute ride, or in this case, well, 15 minute drive, so in this case it's going to be a half an hour ride. No, 15 minute ride down to the school, do some videoing, and then go and get some milk. So may as well use the bike on the first ride and just see how it goes. And I never asked what the gears are on this. It's four gears, and I'm not sure if it's one down, three up, or all the way up, but we'll soon find out. So there we go. Very exciting. First ride on the bike. Oh, yeah. Tune it. So I've never actually filmed or, you know, recorded anything on a motorcycle before. So this is my setup, and I hope it's gonna work. Right, so there's my helmet. Very cool. Viper F656 retro jobby. I bought one of these chin mounts from Temu. Little sticky thing that sticks on there. I've got my GoPro on a mount thing. I've got my Remover wind jacket on. It looks like it's at a very good angle. Once you've got the helmet on and I'm, you know, pretending to be in the riding position, it looks like it should be a good position. If you're wondering what the string is for, It's attached to a carabiner, which once I put the helmet on, I will clip that to one of my, well, somewhere on my person, so that in the event of this ever falling off, the GoPro isn't going to go bouncing down the road. And I do this on my mountain biking anyway, and this is all not thanks to, but thanks to something that happened to Mark Collingwood when he was in the at the Long Mynd, and his mount snapped and his daughter's GoPro 7 Black went bouncing off into the undergrowth. So as soon as I got back, I did this, because if it's happened once, it could happen again. So that's the GoPro. I think the angle's right. Now, as for recording sound, oh, and I'll be powering the GoPro again off my battery pack, which I do for the mountain biking. Now, I bought my partner a little action cam for videoing horsey stuff, so that any drivers pass her too close, you can report them to police, because they're twats. It came with a little microphone. So I've bought this like double extender thing for the power cable from the battery pack. So that will plug into the GoPro, and it's got a separate one for, it says headphones, but I've plugged the microphone into that. So I'll clip that on underneath here, and hopefully that'll work. If not, it'll just be picking up through there. So when I go out, this will be a tester for the system. We'll see how it goes. But anyway, that's what I'm using. Right then, in a bit.
Okay, I'm at my partner's house. I was gonna say Jessalyn, that's Jess.
No,
that's Jessie. And this is Yasmin. She's just subscribed to my channel. There she is, look. Old Northern EMTV, she's just subscribed.
Do not get me in this video.
And she is number 950 forever. Right, see you girls. Enjoy the cooking.
You better believe that.
No. No. Right. You will see yourself on video. Right, see you ladies. Enjoy your cooking. Don't forget your washing, Jess. I'm not touching your smalls. Right then, here we go. Right, there the ladies there, look, there they are. Way! Right then. I've had to change my footwear because I've noticed that the life on engine, it's the gear lever, is designed for Chinese people with small feet, and it was, with my normal shoes on, it was difficult to get your foot in there. So I've put my Shimano cycling shoes on. Look, there's the girls videoing me. Hey ladies, switches off, petrol on. Wowzers, I know the gears are one down, three up, so. Here we go. I haven't ridden a motorbike since 1989, and that was my RM125. Switches off, lights on, right, excitement. Like I say, I hope you can hear this. I'm not sure if it's picking it up through the GoPro microphone or the little separate microphone I've got, so we'll just have to hope for the best. All right then, let's go then to the horse field. One down, three up. Okay, let's go. Whoop. This is brill. Gonna take it easy because I'm running the engine in. I hope the camera angle's okay, and it's not been distorted by the fly squatter. Okay. Break it back into third. Second, check both ways, and away we go. Jimmy joggers. And away we go. Adjust the mirror. Nelson Hill roundabout, turn right to go into Hereford, and we are going to be turning left. Straight on is Worcestershire. What if the copper wants a race? Bit of a wind up today. Quite blustery. Sutton St. Nicholas, there's Sutton St. Nicholas Newtown. Hey up, got a speed copper. Best be careful of that because the speeds I'll be going, I could find myself fined. Right, not far from the school now. The horse playground. Fucking horses, fucking horses. Indicators working, excellent. Look behind, nothing behind me. It's just up here. There's Jacqueline, she's in there already on Charlie. Here we are. Hey, Paddy! Neutral selected. Brilliant. Hello, Paddy! Paddy! Hello, darling.
Just done some videoing using Jackie's phone so she can see it, and I'm holding the feckin' hearse while she puts up a little jump. There she is. So, yeah. And then it's go and get some milk. Hey up, Charles, what are you doing? Nice bit of a bling on his head there. So this is me holding a feckin' brown hearse. Right, we've done the horse filming now. Gonna go and get some milk from Home Bargains. Really nice little ride out here. First time since, bloody hell, late 80s or whatever. Yeah, it's just the gear lever's a bit tight for a European size 11-12. So other than that, bloody brill. Right, gonna get kitted up. Jackie's finished doing the horse playing and all that good stuff.
Right, we're gonna leave the horse playground now. I've disconnected the microphone thing because I think the lead is causing a connection problem with the GoPro, so I've just put the power cable straight from the battery pack into the GoPro, and I'll have a look at it another time. Right then, so leaving the horse playground, off to Hereford.
Right,
so this is us now at Aylston Hill, the bottom of Aylston Hill. We're going to go straight on into Hereford. Turn right. You go down the Roman Road, turn left, it takes you to Worcester. We're going into Hereford. So, dropping down into Hereford, historic market town of the Marches. They'll go over the new bridge and then back up Bridge Street, going over the old bridge and through a bit of town that way. Is the new bridge. There's the old bridge. Looking over to the Black Mountains over there, River Wye. Right, going up Bridge Street now, go over the old bridge. It's great not having to worry about a clutch. Really nice. Thank you. Commented on the scooter. Nice bike, mate. Right, we've got Home Bargains now, just over there. Do the milk run. Thank you very much. Doo-doo-doo. Do a pocket with a mobility scooter. Or in a disabled. What? Oh, let's chuck it, you're Andy boy.
Right, just been to Home Bargains. Loaded up the butty box. Three containers of milk. If you haven't tried these, I suggest you try them. They're bloody lovely. Kind of on par with those gorgeous babies. And we've got some wheat crunches. Right, let's close it up. Ain't butty boxes on bikes brilliant?
Right, let's get from here. All right, honey boy, let's get from here. Gonna have a cup of tea. Tidy. Right, the next job today, we gotta go and get a load of hay for the feckin' Harrises to eat. Cool, mate, away you go. Whee.
So I got some fuel the other day from the garage and topped it up, and the fuel gauge was showing 3/4 when it was full. I've just gone back from this little ride and it's showing just above empty. So let's pop the bonnet and see what's going on. Now I've got a locking fuel cap on here. So red tag. Right, so let's see how much fuel we've actually got in there. Because the fuel guesstimator is showing... I'm sure about half a... I don't know, really. Well, I need to do some work on the fuel range. But yeah, you can see it in there. Anyway, it's certainly not above the red in real life. Right, we've got the beast back in the shed now. I've topped it up with petrol and the fuel guesstimator gauge is showing a little bit more. Just checked the spark plug to see how it was running and it's covered in soot. So I just need to adjust the air mixture screws to get things sorted. And I'll do that next week because I'm off to work this week now, back home and all that good stuff. So I'll get that sorted, hopefully Thursday, Friday, and then go for a spin at the weekend. In a bit, peeps. So you know the drill. Like, subscribe, share the love, drop a comment. Until the next Honda C90 content, in a bit, peeps.